We are here in Vegas, the city of Frank Stea, ATGRadio.com. Frank, what's it like to live in Vegas?
It's nice. You know, the thing is that right now, Ellie, we're on the we're in the vicinity of the Las Vegas Strip. We're actually real close to the Strip. But the thing is, when you live here, people think that I live, you know, at Caesar's Palace, but
you
that's
don't?
Not the case now.
But I see you in every fight.
Yeah, well, no, I do. That's the benefit here. You get to go to the fights. You get to go to the big fights, the big ones. You know, New York has some big ones. Los Angeles, California, they have some big ones. But I mean, it's nothing like Vegas for the fight scene, whether it's boxing or MMA. It's just the feel. I mean, if I get to come out here once a month or twice a month to see a fight, it's like I'm a foreigner. It's like I'm coming from out of town, because there are sides of Las Vegas that aren't casinos, that, you know, that aren't the bright lights, that aren't the MGM Grand. There's, you know, there's houses, there's ghettos. There's roaches and rats and stuff like that. So, you know, it's a great city. It's especially where I come from.
Yeah. There's Mandalay Bay, where Manny Pacquiao likes to stay. Amir Khan fought there. Of course, MGM, where all the legends fought. Let me ask you this, Frank. For years I've been interviewing you, and you always told me that Mayweather beats Pacquiao. You always told me Mayweather's the best pound for pound. What do you think? Who do you want to see Mayweather fight next?
You know, and I'm gonna go with this right here. There's two fighters, and it's the two fighters right now that is being rumored to fight him next. If it can't be Canelo next on May 4th, give it to Robert Guerrero. I think Robert Guerrero is gonna give Floyd a tougher fight than many expected. I mean, for God's sakes, this guy's been calling out Floyd for almost 3 years, and he's earned his right, I believe, with the wins over Selcock Aydin and Andre Berto, and now, you know, he's the mandatory for the welterweight championship that Floyd Mayweather holds. But, I mean, at the end of the day, the mega fight is Floyd Mayweather and Saul Canelo Alvarez. I mean,
Pacquiao fight is no longer of interest to you?
Look, if Floyd Mayweather, and, you know, God forbid that happened, but if Floyd Mayweather lost his next fight, that's the only way a fight with him and Pacquiao, I think, holds, you know, that type of luster. You know, we don't want to see Manny Pacquiao fight Floyd Mayweather coming off a knockout loss to Marquez. We want to see the Manny Pacquiao from a year ago, the Manny Pacquiao who
Manny
knocked out
looked
Ricky
great
Hatton.
In the first half of the fight against Marquez. He really looked good. He looked as the best I've seen him in a while. He was winning the fight. He broke Marquez's nose. He got caught.
It's mistakes and conditioning. You know, I think that's what it is. I don't know if his conditioning was there 100%. And there were mistakes. I mean, obviously you made mistakes to get caught with that. He was the bouncing Manny Pacquiao that we were being accustomed to. But he's a lot older. You know, he's a lot older than he once was, where he was bouncing around the ring and knocking out Miguel Cotto and all these other guys, David Diaz. But now that fight's over, I think. I think unless Floyd needed a tune-up, Manny Pacquiao would be that tune-up at this point. That's just in my opinion. No disrespect to Manny. Love Manny. Great fighter, but he's a tune-up for Floyd now.
Manny's a legend. I've seen you in Manny's fights as well.
Yeah, of course. The best fight I've ever seen live, and I've been to hundreds of live fights, was Manny Pacquiao and Juan Manuel Marquez Ford.
And that was something that vibe, the atmosphere, the crowd. If they fight a fifth time, who wins? Can Manny pull it off?
I don't know. But you know what? Just like I told the people that didn't want to see the fourth fight, it's the fight. You know, it was a great fight, the fourth fight. It was the best fight, I think, out of all four of them because of the dramatic fashion it ended. But I think a fifth fight, there's just so many questions. And you hope that those questions get answered in that fifth fight. And I mean, we'll just have to wait and see.
Absolutely. And Frank, you have a radio show. It's on Mondays and Wednesdays. Who are some of the biggest smack talkers you've ever interviewed that if they had like the best smack talk competition? Is it James Toney number one? Does Malik Scott give a... Like, who do you have top five?
You know, you mentioned James Toney. I don't know if I can, like, right off the fly give an order. But, you know, you have James Toney, great, tremendous smack talker. You have Kevin Kingpin Johnson, who's
he's hilarious.
A sensational smack talker. Malik Scott, man, if Malik Scott, I think, would be heavyweight champion in the world of smack talking if he wanted to be. Tyson Fury is another guy. Mm-hmm. I mean, just throwing it there. I mean, there's been a lot of younger guys that have talked smack, and it's kind of ironic. I just mentioned all heavyweights, but there's a lot of good guys out there, and I think that's what lacks some in boxing these days is smack talk.
A guy that could talk and back it up, like it even Mayorga. Don't back it up, just talk.
But Mayorga has been in countless pay-per-view fights. And, you know, just fresh, you know, just off of his.
Well, do you think we live in too much of a PC world that people are worried that they may say the wrong thing and step on toes? Do you think maybe that's what it is?
Well, you know, some guys aren't in the position, I guess, to feel that they can do that. Everybody wants to, you know, be humble and respectful. But, I mean, this is the fight game, guys. I mean, for one, I'm not a guy who's ever stepped inside a ring without headgear. You know, I've never stepped in a ring. I'm sorry, inside a ring without headgear or with 8-ounce gloves. So maybe I don't have a right to talk. But I think, you know, it's missing the dramatics. I mean, you need to tell a person that you're gonna knock them the fuck out when you fight them. You don't like them. If your girlfriend's there, I might just punch her too. You know, give us a reason to go. Ooh, give us a reason to write headlines.
Danny Garcia, I mean Angel Garcia, Zab Judah, classic.
I mean Angel Garcia. I mean look,
you forgot him in your smack talk list.
The good guy bad guy thing. The good guy bad guy thing. I mean look, good cop bad cop. Danny Garcia and Angel Garcia. I love it. I think it's great. You know. The rug isn't being pulled over my head, but in this case, they're doing tremendous stuff. Danny Garcia goes in there, the fights. Angel Garcia gets inside the fighters' heads before the fights. I think it's great. I think Danny Garcia can go far with it, and I wish more fighters would do that.
If Mayweather goes ahead and wins his next two fights, is he the greatest ever? If he goes to 45-0,
look, I'm gonna say he's the greatest ever because he's gonna retire undefeated, multi-time world champion. I mean, you can't deny that, and I mean just his whole skill level. But there's gonna be detractors saying, you know, oh, he didn't fight Pacquiao when he should have, he didn't fight Margarito, and I mean it's kind of hard. I mean, you look at the guys that vote for, you know, these awards, and I don't want to disrespect anybody, but there's some people that are in the Hall of Fame that maybe shouldn't be, and this isn't coming from me, this is coming from, you know, a lot of the people, a lot of the critics out there.
Like who?
Well, not a lot of people like the fact that Arturo Gatti is in the Hall of Fame. Me personally, I believe he belongs in the Hall of Fame. I mean, I wouldn't argue if he was, that he's in the Hall of Fame, but a first ballot, when you have guys out there like Nigel Benn, Steve Collins, Meldrick Taylor. I mean, there's so many names I can't even think. I think Donald Curry hasn't been in there. You got a lot of guys in there that may have deserved to go in over Arturo Gatti. But again, the name of the game in the Hall of Fame is fame. So, you know, Sylvester Stallone went in there off his fame. I mean, look, Arturo Gatti was famous. He sold out night after night, arena after arena in the... in Atlantic City.
You know what's crazy about Stallone? I met him once. He's like 5'6", 5'5".
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And he fought as a heavyweight. That must be the shortest heavyweight in history.
You know, look, there's been no there's no secret. Stallone has taken some supplements, PEDs. It's no secret. He got busted with them going into Burma. Nah, he doesn't need to be tested. Who doesn't love Sylvester Stallone? Sylvester Stallone's probably the reason I love boxing with the Rocky movies.
Everybody tells me that. And that and Mike Tyson. Those are the two most common reasons people tell me they love boxing.
That's the only reason why. I was a kid and Mike Tyson was on TV and everybody was watching him. And, you know, dramatic moments when he lost to Buster Douglas. And
you just interviewed Buster Douglas.
That was all right. You know, I mean, you know what's crazy, Ellie? I mean, look at it like this. With you, you interview so many people, I know you forget. I mean, I interview so many people, and instead, it doesn't just become, you know, to me, it's always an honor to talk to some of these greats and some of these legends. But then at the end of the day, the one thing I hope now is that the listeners enjoy it. So, you know, you'd have to ask the people that listen to the show, how was it? Because to me, I try my best with the guys, I try my best with the guests that come on, and I hope that whoever listens to the show enjoys it, and then, you know, we see what happens from there. We go from there.
There you have it, Frank Stay at ATGRadio.com, talking boxing. FaceNewsReport.com, I'm Lee Segback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Segback. And you can follow Frank Stay if you wish.
@FrankStaya.